So, Arbitration has been a pretty nice addition to the game. It's a great endo farm. It provides an interesting new enemy. It gives those of us who've been playing for a while another new challenge mode, and it mixes up some of the older game modes in some interesting ways. I've been having a lot of fun with it since it's been released, and I think I've learned enough to give it a sort of 90% guide. What I mean by this is that I have played five of the game modes and have a fair bit to say about them. However, Infested Salvage is also supposed to be a potential arbitration, but it seems to be extraordinarily rare and I simply have yet to see it. Maybe it's just not been popping up when I've been online, or maybe it hasn't even generated yet, but either way, I just have not played its arbitration form, which puts me in an interesting situation. I really want to do an arbitration guide for Limbo, but if I want to test out that mode, I may have to wait for an unknown amount of time and hope that I'm in a position where I can hop on when it's around. Or I can do what I'm about to do, talk about the five more common modes that I have experienced, as well as some general arbitration things like the new enemy, and give a general primer about what's up with Infested Salvage based on what I know about its normal form and what I have read about its arbitration. If I later find out something new about Infested Salvage arbitration, I'll make an updated video, but it does seem better to get something out that seems like it'll cover everything important, rather than not being able to release this video for who knows how long, so that I might be able to include some additional information about a variation of one of people's least favorite game modes. Anyways, now that I'm done showing everyone the massive hole in my own guide, let's cover some of the general things you need to know about that apply to all arbitrations. First, yes, you die if you go down. This is a pretty major thing for anyone, and Limbo isn't going to be an exception to this. Though with the normal durability setup that I showcased in my build videos, you should be relatively safe for a very long time, despite the high-level enemies and the new arbitration drone's annoying way of screwing with your lifestrike ability. You see, if that drone gets near an enemy, they'll make that enemy immune to damage, which means that if a drone wanders into a pack of enemies that you're lifestrike tanking, you will suddenly have all of your on-hit and dot-based lifesteal removed from that group. So you'll now just be a standard armorless limbo in the pack of healthy high-level enemies. So, unfortunately, while you can still dive in from time to time and maul a pack of enemies, you won't be able to just get a good bleed weapon and go ham with life strikes the way you could in something like Elite Sanctuary Onslaught. Which is pretty important, because those drones also mean you will definitely have to come out of the rift on occasion, even if you're one of those types of limbos who tries to stay in there 24/7. You see, those drones, as well as everything they tether to, cannot be sent to the rift and are pulled out of the rift if a link is formed. What this means is that even if they walk into your cataclysm, they will not be sent to the void, and you can't even harm them if you're both inside of the same cataclysm. You will always need to leave the rift to try and kill them, which means you'll still want to mod for at least some durability in your build. There is a nice flip side to this, though, since they aren't in the normal plane. If you're in a rift, they and what they're tethered to cannot harm you or anything that you've banished. So there is a degree to which you can sort of ignore them on most missions, though seriously, they aren't much less annoying to other frames, and they're squishier than you are, and damage or kill everything tied to them when they die, so you should be killing them whenever you can. Especially since removing them is incredibly easy. Just drop out of the rift, blow them up, and then pop right back into the rift if you feel in danger. They're a bit agile, but they're really not a problem to get rid of, especially if you have an AoE weapon like the Arcoplasmor, or if you're good with something like a sniper rifle. And it's a good thing these guys are so easy to get rid of, because while they aren't threatening to the objective on most mission types, on interception you really will have to pay attention to these little pests. Any enemies that they are shielding can just walk right through your stasis cataclysm, go up to the terminal, and hack it without being stopped by you unless you leave the rift and deal with that drone. This means that my normal strategy of just dropping a cataclysm on a terminal and walking away is rather less trustworthy, especially since the enemy nodes will charge up faster than your teams. While your group can handle losing just one point without too much issue, it's still a fairly significant setback, so try to only shield points that you can either get to quickly or are fairly sure aren't going to be attacked soon. Also, if you see a point that your shielding start to get taken, and you're not in a team that's used to Limbo here, I actually suggest you drop your Cataclysm. You see, since you will know that the point is under attack from an Arbitration drone who will not be stopped by your stasis, and you can't really expect a Pug teammate to know that they have to stay outside of Cataclysm to hit said drone, by dropping Cataclysm you actually make it more likely that they can clear the point in time, and you can just reset your bubble whenever you get back into a position to do so. You could also try explaining that to those guys that they need to be targeted from outside of the bubble in text or over voice, but between language barriers and people just not actually paying attention to you, I'll give you only about a 1 in 3 chance of that actually helping. However, none of this means that you need to completely change off of the usual strategy of just shielding a point and sort of leaving it. All that is actually different is that you should stay closer if you can, and be prepared to make up for some occasional issues thanks to the new drones. Thankfully, most of the other game modes don't really have much that's really changed about how you should play them beyond, you know, just having to deal with the Arbitration drones, but I will go ahead and give a general strategy for each of them. For defense, it's always going to be a guard the NPC type, so just bring a long duration Limbo and banish the NPC. This will keep him almost perfectly safe without interfering with your team or slowing the mission down, and since he has a bit more health than normal, you'll have even less to worry about than on a normal sortie defense. Large bubble setups are an option here too, and can be very effective against Grineer and Infested, but between the nullifiers on Corpus missions and the Arbitration drones that you will hit on every mission type, that playstyle can actually end up being fairly annoying to deal with, even if it is incredibly safe. As for excavation, the same two strategies as outlined in my earlier excavation video should work just fine. Decent-sized bubbles will be ideal for Infested as they keep power carriers from blowing up the excavator and can still be used perfectly well against the Grineer, but when you're dealing with the Corpus, taking your small range build so that nullifiers aren't an issue is probably what you want to do. The only new thing here is actually an old thing that just didn't used to be a problem unless doing an excavation mission for a good long while. Because the excavators have such low HP and your enemies are so high level, you will need to make extra sure to push enemies back from your excavator before you refresh your bubble. Other than that little trick, and having to refresh more than once, there is really nothing new to say here. Similar situation with survival, which is probably Limbo's second weakest form of Arbitration, though he does still do alright here. He's mostly going to be a gunner who can occasionally paralyze groups of enemies if needed, but that generally won't be that important, and again, Arbitration drones kind of make the big bubble thing really annoying. What's far better is if you're working with someone who can benefit from being banished, like Excalibur, who you can just send to the Rift and have chew up everything on the map without any risks to themselves. You can also run a Rift Torrent build, though even with the Arbitration mission's buffed enemy levels, you'll still probably be well past 50 minutes in before Rift Torrent becomes a better option than just better weaponry. As for Arbitration Defection, it is a place where Limbo is probably going to be the single strongest option in the game. Just equip the Haven Augment, banish a group of NPCs, and then run them from their spawn all the way to the exit. If their health ever starts to get low, boot them out of the void, and then re-banish them for a nice chunk of healing. No need to mess with any life support capsules or even really guard them all that closely. If they're at full health and freshly banished, they'll usually be able to make it all the way to the next waypoint without you needing to actually guard them, so feel free to take the time to fill up capsules for your teammates or kill enemies if you feel the need. Nothing can take them out of the void, nothing can harm them in there, and if you've got Haven, you can keep healing them if they ever start to get low. The only issues that can happen here is that, yes, you'll be banishing a lot, which means you'll probably be banishing any nearby teammates fairly often, just, it's gonna happen. And if you enter a mission and discover you're the only healer in the group, you're gonna have a seriously fun time trying to defend two separate groups of NPCs. Though since banish makes the NPCs invincible, it is possible if you're relatively quick moving. But if you do have another healer on the team, what's far better is to just solo one group of NPCs while your team focuses on the other, and you can get through this mission with basically no worries beyond just growing too bored with it. Finally, let's move on to Infested Salvage, and I haven't had a chance to play it in its Arbitration form yet, and honestly, I wouldn't actually mind it if it never appeared, since if you're not in a team, you probably should not take Limbo here. I really hate saying that. The fact that my channel's like 90% about Limbo should make that fact really obvious. But it's true, Limbo has some serious issues here, and they are ones that I assume have not been fixed for the arbitration version. You see, you cannot access the terminals when banished or cataclysmed, so no charging them up while in the void. And you need to be killing enemies as fast as possible, which means stasis is not going to be a big help, especially since this is infested salvage, so there aren't any real threats in the map anyways. And since the infested are such a joke, they'll die almost instantly to the majority of even decent weapons, so Rift Torrent is going to be overkill for an absurdly long period of time. But since they are going to be high level and relatively healthy, catabombing won't be a good strategy either. And yeah. Stasis is counterproductive, Cataclysm can't be seriously used for damage, and you can't even set up a large unstasis bubble to give the team bonus energy regeneration. About the only thing that you actually can do beyond just being a gun is to banish anyone who can rock in the void and then pick up and use their share of CPU things for them. And that's seriously about it. You can take Limbo here, and well, I'm me, so I probably will. But yeah, guys, I'm sorry to say this, but I really haven't found or heard of a way to make Limbo a legitimately good pick on infested salvage. Maybe this has been changed for the arbitration version, I haven't had a chance to play it, but I seriously doubt it. Thankfully, it seems to be an extremely rare game mode for arbitration, and since I think it's always going to be against the infested, it doesn't really matter much whether you pick a good frame for it or not. Just be aware that while you can still contribute to the team as just a fighter, there is not going to be a whole lot beyond that that'll distinguish Limbo from any of the other warframes in the game. Anyways, that's my slightly limited guide to arbitration. I'm sorry that it ended on a bit of a downer, but being solid to amazing for 5 out of 6 game modes is certainly not bad. Limbo is, in general, one of the better picks for arbitration, and while you're going to have to learn to work around the effects of the drones and be a bit more careful than normal, if you are reasonably skilled, it's not hard to last for as long as you need while being a great addition to your team. As always, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you learned anything, please leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you later. Farewell.